right, then I hope y'all are having an amazing day today. So we're gonna get into the video. She tried to play dumb after running over two people. I'm gonna give you guys my reaction and a little bit of commentary, my thoughts and opinions. But before we get into that, make sure that you subscribe to the channel, like this video, all that good stuff, man. It's YouTube. Y'all know what to do. It's YouTube, man. But anyways, without getting too deep into all of that, man, shout out to Pegasus for the video. So we're gonna go ahead and get into
woman thought she could get away with running over two people. So the story takes place in Illinois, where basically this woman was caught in a DUI car crash. So DUI is just driving under influence, basically drunk driving. Now this woman actually managed to kill two people because of her reckless actions, and there's actually a 25-minute video of her getting arrested on the Law and Crime channel. Now what's really interesting about her case is how completely heartless she is. You can see when the cops are interviewing her, she has completely, like, no remorse, no empathy. In fact, she's only concerned about when her next day in school is gonna be. Now, a TikTok actually went viral where the cop is talking to her about the incident, and basically she just ignores everything the cop says and asks him when he's gonna give her her car back so she can go to school. She still doesn't understand that she's going to jail for a very long time.
Oh, hey, you never answered me about my car, and then... I have school tomorrow, so how do I get my car for tomorrow?
Well, your car is totaled.
It's what?
Your car is
totaled.
Totaled? Totaled, wrecked.
Okay, so how do I get it for
you don't.
So, I don't go to school tomorrow, is what you're telling me?
No, ma'am. You want me to be honest with you? You're going to jail, you don't have a bond, you killed two people tonight. I don't think you understand that.
Okay, so you're probably a little confused at this point, you know, probably thinking, what the fuck is up with her? Later on, the officer gets pretty pissed and he just kind of loses it and tells her exactly what happened.
That's sad and pathetic and horrible all at the same time.
Which is understandable, honestly. But interesting context to this interview is that it's not like days after the situation or she got like some trauma injury to her head that she can't remember anything. This is literally right after the incident, and she sustained no injuries, at least to her head. In fact, right before this, she had to do a bunch of tests to check if she was drunk, right? You gotta walk in a straight line, you gotta lift your leg a little bit, try to balance or something, you gotta blow into this machine.
You know, every time you see a situation like this, usually the person who is drunk, they are the one to survive. A lot of times, y'all know what I'm talking
machine,
about.
Which, I think it's checking for ethanol levels, you know, alcohol levels in your, I don't know, system. So she couldn't complete the exercises and she was 100% drunk. So there's a couple of possibilities here that I wanted to go over. Number one is the classic insanity defense. You've probably seen this a bunch of times on the internet. Basically, whenever a criminal is caught and they don't know what to do, they just start acting insane because that way, maybe they can convince the judge and the jury that they were actually insane and they weren't in control of their actions. So they'll be put in a mental hospital rather than going to prison. But that only really works if you've been consistent the entire time. And the problem is, right before this, when she was, you know, following all the instructions for the drunk test, and when she was talking to the cops who were asking for her name and everything to write down, she was perfectly normal, which means she's definitely not insane.
You do not have a bond. You are not getting out of jail. Your car is property of East Peoria Police Department because it's a crime scene. It killed two people tonight. You are clueless with that, clearly. I've already explained this to you. You're going to jail for reckless homicide tonight. You're going to jail for aggravated DUI for killing two people. That's what's going on. So no, you're not going to school tomorrow. You're not getting your car out of impound.
Okay, what the heck is wrong with her? You're not going to jail for one day. What kind of justice system would that be? You know, you run over two people, get two people killed, you know, forever removed from this universe, and you get one day in jail. Like, what fantasy world do you live in? And why the hell are you so goddamn worried about your Tuesday night class? What, you got an exam or something? Whatever is happening, you got an assignment, an exam, that is like the least of your worries right now. Option two, I don't know how likely this is, but she may just be a heartless psychopath who does not actually care that she killed two people. Now the thing is, if you are a regular person and you accidentally, suppose, right, you run over two people and you end up killing two people, your normal response is probably gonna be hordes of guilt. You know, the first thing you're probably gonna say is, sorry, I didn't mean to, I'm sorry this happened, I hope the families you know, are doing okay. You know, any sort of stuff that kind of demonstrates some sort of empathy, right? Which clearly she has none. Now, option three, which a lot of people are theorizing, is that this is some sort of a trauma response. Basically, it must have clocked in her head that she ran over two people and that she's going to jail for a very long time. And in order for the brain to protect her from this horrific state of reality, it's telling her that, hey, you're gonna go to school tomorrow.
What happened prior to the accident?
I was coming to full throttle, and I was almost here, as you can see.
Were you driving this way, or that coming down that side road?
I was coming here, this way.
Okay.
And suddenly, one person walked out in front of me.
Okay.
And my car got hit. I called you as soon as they got hit.
You called 911?
Yes, I called 911. As soon as something happened.
So she ran over somebody who was walking. Okay. Because this is some one person walked out in front of me. Run that back.
I called you as soon as suddenly one person walked out in front of me.
Okay. Walked out in front of me. Okay, now this makes a whole lot more sense why she don't have no injuries. Okay, that makes sense. Of course you're not going to have no injuries. You walk with somebody, run over somebody walking. Anyway, so
My car got hit. I called you as soon as they got
my
hit.
My car
you
got
called
hit.
911?
Yes, I called 911. As soon as something happened. And then someone said, oh, someone else is hit. I'm just like, oh my God, how did that happen?
It's pretty plain and simple. You were drunk driving and ran over two people, and you were a horribly irresponsible human being. In fact, I didn't actually know this, but drunk drivers are some of the most hated people on the planet. Just because of the quantity of incidents that actually happen and how easily it could be prevented. Now, after this, the cop is just in complete disbelief. He's just asking her, like, are you even hearing the words I'm saying?
Did you just hear what I just told you?
You said I'm not going tomorrow. I'm talking about Tuesday.
Did you hear what I said?
You said I'm going to jail tomorrow.
You're going to jail when we're down here?
Yes.
Did you understand what I told you, that you killed two people tonight?
Yes. I'm just wondering when I can go to school.
Okay. We're done.
Bro, what? 14 years.
Am I going to school tomorrow? No, bitch, you're going to jail for 14 years! I think our justice system needs a little rework, a little patch update. There's literally two people that you took, you know, two families that are completely heartbroken, never coming back. I don't really know what the right sentence is, but this just feels too short, especially because of the lack of empathy. Like, there's no sorry. You know, literally saying sorry could probably reduce your sentence, but no sorry, no remorse, nothing like that. Just like, when can I go to school next? Like, what the fuck is this rotten prison? I thought when it comes to, like, murder and stuff, it comes to, like, life imprisonment. I don't know, I'm not a goddamn judge, but basically after this, the cop continues to try to explain it to her, and she's still concerned about school. That must be one hell of a teacher, man. I don't know, do they carry a flamethrower and just burn you if you don't submit your homework? Because, like, why are you so concerned about this? It's really sad how many people actually have to die from drunk driving, but the thing that really freaks me out about this is just that hollowness and lack of concern about anything.
You're all on body camera being completely careless about killing two.
You know, I think that charge under the law is somewhat the consistent charge, because Henry Ruggs, I don't know if y'all know, a football player got convicted. I used to love Henry Ruggs. I'm a big Alabama fan, and he got convicted. I think he getting like 10 years or something like that for, he was in Vegas. And he was going like 170 miles an hour, and he killed this lady who was in her car, her and a dog or something like that. Anyway, what I'm saying is this seems to be like around 10, I think he get like 10 to 15 or something like that, or maybe 10 to 20. Anyway, that 10 to 20-ish range seems to be the consistent charge for this kind of thing, but let's keep
people tonight. You could care less. That's sad and pathetic. And horrible all the same time.
Can you say that as a cop?
Yes, ma'am, I can.
Okay, so can I ask?
Can you say that as a cop, right? Wow, suddenly you care so much about the rules. Because you just love to follow the rules, right? Of course he can say that as a cop.
Wait,
he just said it's horrible.
She hit somebody in her color. Bruh, I gotta... Wait a minute, her car looked like this? Wait a minute, go back.
You say that as a cop, right? Wow, suddenly you care so much about the rules. Because you just... love to follow the rules, right? Of course he can say that as a cop. He just said it's horrible and pathetic that you killed two people while drunk driving and have literally no remorse, no regret, no sorry, nothing like that. It is horrible and pathetic, and that's a perfectly reasonable thing to say in the situation. He's not, like, violating his cop duties or something. You did a horrific crime, and you were caught doing the crime. I'll tell you, it's actually horrible and pathetic, the fact that she's completely aware of the situation, that she was able to ask the cop that question, so all that insanity stuff goes out the window. This shit freaks me out,
man. That's a great point.
Clip this video, or I overdose.
That's a great point. That's an excellent point. She was cognitive enough to say that, ask questions about schools. She knew what she was doing. Hoping that he'll say, yeah, you go to school. So she realized that she was going to jail. 14 years. Let me know if y'all think that's the correct sentence, man. This is a sad situation. And you see these situations happening all the time. Almost every other day, we get a situation with somebody drunk driving. And like I said earlier, usually the drunk driver is the one who's still here. The person who committed the event, you rarely see, at least from what I've seen, that everybody in that event passes away. It'd be like, nah, the person who was drunk driving, they made it. Anyways, man, let me know what y'all think down below in the comment section. I'll see y'all in the next video.